Friends, here in this video, you will learn how this automotive horn is working, how it functions, and how to repair an automotive horn if it is going bad or if it is going defective. So I will show you in this video how this is performed. In my case, it is Fedra 12 volt and low pitch is 410 hertz, 410 hertz pitch is there for low, and this is providing a low pitch. So this is what is the regular horn which is used on car, motorcycle and bikes everywhere. So we are going to provide 12 volt from our adapter to this horn, and let us see if it is banging or not. So see, this is not producing a tone which a horn should produce. So what we will do is, I am going to open this horn in front of you. What you need is a Phillips screwdriver. Remove all these four screws. Sometimes these are nuts also, and sometimes they are metal tabs, but whatever is in your case, you will have to open this horn, and then we will see inside what is there and how it is functioning and what is going bad. Probably we will see. All four screw removed. Now I'm going to open this. After opening, you can see one part is in my hand and the other part is in my another hand. So this part is, this is known as diaphragm, and here this part is known as plunger. This is a metal plunger which is attracted by electromagnet coil. In a little while I will show you the coil, and here is a collar for this one. This collar is having a special purpose. This collar is making and breaking the contact. I will show you in a little while. So here are these gaskets. They are provided because this diaphragm is vibrating. So for the vibration, these gaskets are helping. So then the covers are not making too much force on this diaphragm. So here the diaphragm is coming same way like this. This is a metal diaphragm. You can see this side is rusted because the water is entering from here while the horn is fixed in a vehicle or in a bike. So sometimes the rainwater is going in, or the service water is going in, and that is making this part rusty. It should be Teflon or something coated, but it is not in my case. It's a cheaper one. So it is. So see, such a sound is produced by this diaphragm while the horn is banging or you are switching on the horn switch. So this is a plastic covering, you can say, and here this one is, this is the metal covering, and this has some parts which I will explore in a little detail here. Here is first, you can see there is a coil. You can see this is the coil, the electromagnetic coil is there. This is, you can say, this is from the aluminium. While I scratched a little bit over here, this is the white, so it means that the aluminium coil had been used. So this is bad coil. They should use copper, but they did not. This is this coil is wound on a former which is plastic. You can see this black plastic, and there is inside there is a metal or magnet. You can see, not magnet but metal. This, maybe the screwdriver is magnet, so that's why. Yeah, the screwdriver is magnet, so that's why it is attracting. And then this coil, they have a continuity from here to here. This underneath this small plate which is armature, this is armature. These two plates are armature, they are making armature. So this downside plate, which is moving plate, this is the fixed plate and this is the moving plate. This moving plate is connected to this coil other end, and here is the first end of this coil. So this coil, if it is burning or they had, it had no continuity, then what you can do, you can use a copper wire like this, 21 gauge 20 gauge copper wire you can use to rewind this coil. In some horns, here are screws or whatever nut bolts, nuts are provided, so you can open these contacts and you can remove all these parts, and then you can access to the coil, and the coil you can rewind some way like this. But in this case, here are rivets. You can see these are the rivets they have provided. So the rivets you can open even, and you can provide small screws or small nuts, nut bolts over here, and they will do. But in our case, what we will do is, first we will check the coil because coil seems to be good, and then we will check another part. See this armature. This armature is, here is the fiber part, and here underneath is the metal. You can see here is the metal and here is the metal also, and there are contacts. Two contacts are there. This is closing and opening contacts. You can see the CB contacts set is there, and here is another thing which is the adjustment screw, and here is the rubber grommet. This rubber grommet is holding this upper or fixed contact in its place, and this screw which is over here, you can see this is the screw which we can adjust by screwdriver. I will show you in the end how we are adjusting. This is for the pitch and for the horn banging. It's important that we have to adjust it correctly. If it is not correctly adjusted, then the horn will not bang. So this CV point should also be cleaned, and it should be perfect in order, so then it will should pass the current, and it should not be carbonized or something like that. If it is carbonized, then you can use a piece of emery paper and you can clean that contact. In my case, it is cleaned. I will show you in a little while how to check it. Using our multimeter, we can verify both of the things, which is the coil and the armature CB points. We can verify both of the items. I'm going to show you how we are doing this work with the help of a multimeter. So here is my multimeter. What we will do is we will select the continuity range. From here I'm selecting the continuity. So now you can see this is selected on the continuity, and it will show ohms also. So you can see continuity is coming. So then what we can do is we have to check the coil first. So the coil we will check from here. This is the first point, and then there the underneath the moving contact is the second point. So here the continuity should come. As you can see, the continuity is coming. So if the contact we are going to check, we have to check from here to here. So the contact is also coming in the way. Both things are coming in series. I mean to say the contact and the coil is coming in series, and it is giving me some reading 1.2 ohm, 1 ohm, something like that, and continuity is coming. So it means that both the coil and the contacts are good. If they something is bad, I mean to say the coil is bad, it should not continue, and if the point is bad, so then it should also not continue. But in my case, as this this resistance is coming 1 ohm, and meter is banging, the inside buzzer is sounding, so it means that the coil as well as the CV point both are good, and they are good in shape. So what we can do here, you just see how it's functioning is, I will explain a little bit. This part, which is the fiber part, and this is attached to the moving contact or moving armature, this armature strip it is connected to, and here the point also is connected. So here this one, which is in my hand, this diaphragm, here is the collar. So this collar is placed on this armature moving contact or moving strip or whatever this fiber strip this is placed on. So while we are supplying power over here, so then first these contact points are close together, and by the spring, because this is a spring type plate, you can see this is a spring type plate. It is coming by force upward, so it is up, and then these contacts are joined together. I mean to say they are closed, and then power can pass in between these two terminals. And then while power is passing, so the electromagnet, it is becoming the magnet, and it is attracting this part inside, this plunger inside, because magnet is attracting metal. So this is metal, and it is attracted inside. So the collar, which is touching to this part, I mean to say, which is holding on the pivoted on this small plate, so it is also pressed with the with this collar. So while it is pressed, the current path is disconnected. I mean to say both of the points are disconnected, and there is no more magnet, and then the coil magnetic field is vanished and it is collapsed. So then this plunger is going backward with the help of this spring, and all the time this vibration is produced by this armature, this diaphragm, and this diaphragm is banging. I mean to say the horn is banged in this way. So this is the way how it is working. Now what we will do is we will fix the things back, because what the items which I have checked in front of you, I mean to say the coil and the CB point, both are good. So we are packing these things, and I'm going to show you how we will bang this horn. I mean to say how we will correct the problem with this horn. So here I put all the whatever these gaskets, and now I'm going to fix this item on this covering on this plastic cover, this metal cover I'm fixing on, and then we'll put all four screws back in the horn. So both of the body halves will be joined together. So don't skip this video. If you will skip it somewhere, you will not understand what I am doing. So now you can see I fixed it, firmly fix all screws, because this part, these screws should be fixed because this covering is also part of the horn. Now we will see if we have continuity over here. We should have continuity over here also. We have continuity over here also. Now we will provide power and let us see if the horn is banging or not. So see, this horn is banging. Why it is? Because of this screw we adjusted. So let us see how it is affecting the sound. I will fix this power over here and adjust this screw. So let us see. Now I adjust it for the maximum sound. This way we repaired this horn, and hopefully you understand the purpose of this screw. So if you have some bad horn, you can repair it very easily, and you can do your diagnostic on your horn and you can bring it to the life once again. So if you like this video, please give a big thumbs up, subscribe on my channel, press on bell icon and press on all, so then you will get notifications on each upload. Thank you for watching.